Hello, dear children. Deepjani ma'am is here with another story for you all. Today's story is a well-known story written by Grimm's Brothers. And the title of the story is The Shoemaker and the Elves. This story is a perfect example of how one good turn deserves another. This means that when we feel grateful towards the person who has helped us and try to do something good for that person in return. Okay? So this is what it means when we say one good turn deserves another. So, shall I begin with the story? Well, today I thought of narrating the story in a different manner. How about listening to the story in a poem form? Sounds exciting, isn't it? There are two lines in the poem which are repeated in the story. And they are boo, baba boo, and rat-a-tat-tat. Tell me what happened after that. These are the lines that you need to repeat, keeping the rhyme, rhythm, and beat. So let me begin the story of the shoemaker and the elves. This is a story of the cute little elves who made some shoes and kept them on the shoemaker's shelf. It all began when the poor shoemaker said,
"I don't know what will happen when there is no leather left. No matter how hard I work each day, nothing is working in my favor these days."
So, worried and sad, the shoemaker decides to go to sleep. But before that, planned out what is to be done in the following week. Just before he turned out the light, he took out that last piece of leather and cut it just right. He got into bed and was snoring away. When two elves appeared, but not to play. "Boo, baba boo, and rat-a-tat-tat. Tell me what happened after that." The elves hammered and nailed, they stitched and sewed. They did not stop till the rooster crowed. Their needles went up, their needles went down. The shoes were a masterpiece in every way. They took the shoemaker's breath away.
"Wow, such lovely shoes. Who made them? I did not make."
"Boo, baba boo, and rat-a-tat-tat. Tell me what happened after that." The shoes were neat, oh so nice. The shoemaker sold them for double the price. All that money took away his blues. He bought fine leather for two pair of shoes. The elves came back the following night and finished the shoes by the bright moonlight. The shoemaker sold them the following day. Folks came running and willing to pay. "Please, please, please give us those shoes. They are beautiful. They are lovely. We are ready to pay double the price for these lovely shoes." "Boo, baba boo, and rat-a-tat-tat. Tell me what happened after that." The shoemaker cut. The elves sewed the stitches. In time, the shoemaker increased his riches. One night, near Christmas, the shoemaker and his wife went to see who were those kind and helpful friends. They stayed up very late that night and peeped through the curtain. Oh my! What a sight! Boo, Baba Boo, and a rat-a-tat-tee! Tell me real quick, what did they see? Two little elves came into the room, sewing the shoes to complete the work soon. They've made us rich and happy too. We are thankful, said Wifey. What shall we do?
Oh, let's make them clothes for a Christmas gift. It will keep them warm and give their spirits a lift.
So the shoemaker and his wife sewed shirts and trousers to fit just right and left them for the elves on Christmas night. Boo, Baba Boo, and a rat-a-tat-tat. Tell me what happened after that. When the elves came out under darkened skies, they were in for a big surprise. Instead of leather, they found clothes, you see. They tried them on and danced with glee. Boo, Baba Boo, and a rat-a-tat-tat. Tell me what happened after that. The happy elves never came again, but the shoemaker and his wife never forgot them. So children, the elves helped the shoemaker in his time of need. And in return, the shoemaker too was grateful to the two little elves and wanted to thank them in some way. So he chose Christmas time to gift new clothes and shoes to the kind elves to show his appreciation of the help that he received from them. The elves too were very, very happy to receive the gifts. Now, children, as Christmas is round the corner, how about becoming a Santa and making someone happy? Think about that one such gift that you love the most and would now like to gift it to others to bring a smile on their lips. Think about it, and we shall discuss about the same in our English class. Okay, so bye bye for now till we meet again.